In 2010, the rule of thumb was to spend 70% of a movie's budget on marketing. So if a film had a budget of $100 million, $70 million of that would go to advertising the movie. But in the following years, this expenditure grew drastically. So much so, in fact, that the cost of producing the film could be a fraction of the marketing costs. Low-budget horror films are a great example of this. The Purge, Insidious 1 and 2, Dark Skies, Sinister, Skyline, and Your Next had production budgets under $5 million and marketing budgets over $20 million. There is no doubt that movie marketing has become increasingly important, and the most influential factor is the movie's trailers. Movie trailers have become an industry and an art, but most interesting is how they have changed and progressed since their creation. I did some research and divided the history into five eras. The first is simply called the beginning. It ranged from 1926 to the 1950s, but I split it into two sub-eras, the first titled, What Are We Doing? This is titled so because trailers had just been invented and people were trying to figure out the new mechanism in different ways. But for the large part, the trailers were clips from the film with words over it. It wasn't trying to get across what the film was about, just the general idea of what you could watch. I call the second sub-era So Much Talking, and it sounds just like what you may think. Once films with sound attached to them came out, the first being the jazz singer, they utilized the new medium to the max. Trailers would consist of someone talking about the film, how excited people were about the film, who did what, and so on. For example, the trailer for Citizen Kane.
How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? This is Orson Welles. I'm speaking for the Mercury Theater, and what follows is supposed to advertise our first motion picture. Citizen Kane is the title, and we hope it can correctly be called a coming attraction. It's certainly coming to this theater, and I think our Mercury actors make it an attraction.
They have a narrator who is very aware that this is an advertisement for a movie. It says little to nothing about the story, but takes care to go through each and every actor in the movie, oftentimes going on for 7 minutes. So in conclusion, in the beginning era, very little was said about the film experience itself, but focused on who created it. It was in the 1960s that Stanley Kubrick began a new era in trailers, for the most part. I call this era Montages and Beginning Part 2. The trailer for Dr. Strangelove, or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb, created by Kubrick himself, was revolutionary. It wasn't self-aware that this was a movie, and no one provided a voiceover to explain what you were seeing. He first experimented with this idea earlier in his Lolita trailer, but with less success. Still, the trailers were met with a bit of apprehension and didn't immediately change how everyone was doing trailers, hence the beginning part 2. So we still had trailers like the one for Psycho, where someone, in this case the director, Alfred Hitchcock, is talking about the film. It is self-aware, has words on the screen, and consists of a lot of talking. Only this time, he talks about the story, or rather the murders, and not the actors. This idea was taken even further in the next era. The era I call Teasing the Narrative started in 1970, but didn't really become popular until Spielberg's Jaws trailer. It was shorter, only 3 minutes long, was grounded almost completely in the fictional world, and most importantly teased the story you would see if you bought a ticket. Trailers in this era consisted of a lot less talking and showed the premise of the film without spoiling it. For example, the highly regarded trailer for Ridley's Alien. This type of trailer was a huge success, but it had a negative effect, resulting in the next era in 1990. I call it spoilers everywhere. Movie studios started realizing what I like to call the Meet Joe Black Law. See, Meet Joe Black was a 1998 film where Brad Pitt plays death and tries his hand at being human, only he falls in love. In short, it was a romance. So it may come as a surprise to hear that the majority of the tickets to the film were bought by young adult men. This is because the trailer for Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace, played before the film and you couldn't see the trailer anywhere else. Therefore, Meet Joe Black did very well in the box office because droves of people bought tickets, despite that they left before it even started. The Meet Joe Black law says that a film makes money when it gets people into the theater, though making them stay is unnecessary. So you could anger the theater and everyone could leave, yet you still get your money. Of course, the reviews matter, and that's why you can't show this in the trailer and this in the theater. But movie studios started to realize that they could spoil a movie in the trailer and the ticket sales would increase. This happened notably in the trailers for Terminator 2, Ghost, and especially in comedy movies where the best jokes are all spoiled in the trailer. This era reigned until the success of the Inception trailer in 2010, starting what I like to call the Foghorn era.
I specialize in a very specific type of security. Subconscious security.
You're talking about dreams.
Mr. Carl has a job offer he would like to discuss with you.
What kind of work placement?
Not exactly.
We create the world of the dream. We bring the subject into that dream. And they fill it with their secrets.
Then you break in and steal it.
Well, it's not strictly speaking legal.
These trailers almost got rid of narrators altogether, instead having snippets of dialogue explaining the premise. It focused more on the action and the visual effects than before, including black screens with text, and most notably, low beats or long notes, like that of a foghorn. Whether Inception was the first to do this is debated, though it definitely popularized this trend. This is most likely what you think of when you hear a trailer because of how many movies in the last decade have followed the format. This format is so overdone that the YouTuber Oralnauts created a perfect template for blockbuster movie trailers in their video, How to Make a Blockbuster Movie Trailer.
Have you ever wondered about this particular thing? Because it turns out that that thing is real.
For the most part, we are still in the Foghorn era, though it is possible that we are in the cusp of a new era, one that I call Moody. The widely successful trailers and teasers for Deadpool 1 and 2 and Baby Driver fit into this era. Put simply, these trailers move away from establishing story and instead give off the mood the movie has. A good illustration of this is the promo for season 1 of FX Atlanta.
Oh my god. Why are you up?
I had a weird dream.
It teases the experience you will have when watching and not the narrative. This new era is sure to provide some new and interesting trailers that I, for one, am very excited to see. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and comment your thoughts below.